Hello, this is Marta Yebra, and in this short video from the Vegetation Remote Sensing video series, I want to briefly present how remote sensing can be used to assess the forest land cover change. Changes in forest cover impact the global carbon cycle, the hydrologic cycle, biodiversity, and also are critical to understanding the causes and consequences of land use change. This slide provides an example of deforestation analysis in Brazil using a time series of Landsat imagery. The deforested land and urban areas are in purple. Healthy vegetation appears in green. Systematic cutting of forests starting in 1975 along the roads. And then they found out to create this fishbone pattern that begins in the image of 1986. By 2012, the deforestation has spread out to envelop large areas that were previously rainforest. The primary cause of this deforestation is conversion to cropland and pasture, but the reasons for this conversion are varied, and remote sensing cannot directly tell us a lot about that. An interactive version where you can expand the view is available in this link, which is worth doing as it gives you a feel of the scale over which the deforestation occurs. I tried to attach the video in this presentation, but it didn't work. Also using Landsat data, the University of Maryland has built global maps that show changes in forests and other types of land cover. You can, for example, see the high rate of loss due to deforestation dynamics in the Chaco woodlands of Argentina. Just to give you an idea of the size of the analysis they did, they processed more than 650,000 Landsat 7 images in collaboration with the Google Earth engine, who implemented the models developed at the university. For those that are not familiar with Google Earth Engine, this is a massive parallel technology of high performance processing of geospatial data and houses a copy of the entire Landsat archive. What would have taken a single computer to perform like 15 years was completed in a matter of days using Google Earth Engine computing. Similar facilities are provided by the National Computer Infrastructure here at the Australian National University. So which are the techniques that we can use to detect the changes? Well, we can mainly use three different techniques, and I will expand on each of them later on. First of all, we can use multiple temporal composite. For continuous data, we can use the differences, ratio, principal component analysis, regression analysis, or vector analysis. This kind of analysis need to establish a threshold to determine what's the change. And then if we have categorical data, we can do, for example, cross tabulation of two dates or multi-temporal classification. This is an example of multi-temporal composites. Here you have an NDVI image before of a fire that happened in Spain in 1991. And here one image after the fire. If we assign to the red channel the image before the fire and to the green and blue channel the image after, the result is this image where the fire scar is in red. For continuum or interval scale variables, we can compute different metrics with images of different dates. For example, here we have image differencing of two NDVI images for 1993 and 1999. And with this, we can identify regions that have suffered a decrease in vegetation cover between those two dates. For example, in dark tones here, we see where areas where there was a decrease in NDVI, a very intense decrease, while medium gray tones correspond to areas where soil vegetation has been maintained. So if we plot the histogram of this image, we can use it to find the threshold to determine what we consider stable or what is considered an increase in vegetation cover or NDVI or decrease in this index. Finally, this is an example of cross-tabulation. Again, we have two classified images for two different dates. You can just do a matrix where you have the categories for one time here in this side, or the time two in this other side, and you can see also the direction of the changes. And of course, in blue, in the diagonal, you see the stable where things have not changed at all.